Now then, hello folks and welcome back to my video gaming channel, Retro Gamer Diaries. Today, we're talking about the ZX Spectrum game, Airwolf. Airwolf is a series of shooter video games based on the TV series of the same name. The first game based on the series was released for the ZX Spectrum by Elite Systems in December 1984. The game was also released on the Commodore 64, Amstrad CPC and Atari 8-bit family. A sequel, Airwolf II, was also released in 1986, but we won't talk about that game here. Because today, we're looking at the ZX Spectrum 48K version of the first game. And the author was Richard Wilcox. Now, I love these 80s TV series, such as the A-Team and Knight Rider. For me, Airwolf was a bit of a rip-off to the Knight Rider series, except it was a fancy helicopter rather than that smart-ass talking car. Anyway, so what was the plot of this 40-year-old 8-bit game? Well, as Stringfellow Hawk, a former Vietnam chopper pilot and the only man in the free world trained to fly this billion-dollar helicopter, Airwolf, you have been assigned to a dangerous rescue mission by the firm. Five very important United States scientists are being held hostage deep in a subterranean base beneath the scorching Arizona desert. As Hawk, you must guide Airwolf using full stealth capabilities on a series of very dangerous nighttime missions and bring about the release of each scientist in turn. Only destruction of the defense control boxes strategically positioned within the cavern will allow Airwolf to descend to the heart of the base where the scientists are held. Very exciting so far, isn't it? So what about the gameplay? Well, Airwolf is viewed from the side and puts you in command of an attack helicopter. Moving onto a screen at a time, you must shoot out anything and everything in your path, including lots of regenerating static targets. Realistic gravity takes effect, so you can't simply hover in a set position. The game has you flying the Airwolf helicopter largely in underground caves, with almost no room to move, and precision movement needed to avoid the traps, all while trying to hold the Airwolf in the air. So let's have a look at the game then. Thank you. So how am I going to review this game then? Well, Airwolf did hit the top of the ZX Spectrum sales charts back in 1984, but in reality, it wasn't particularly a good game. Airwolf even received a coveted Crash Smash rating back in the Crash issue 13, but even that never managed to convince me it was any good, even as a teenager. Playing it now, you'd be forgiven for wondering what all this fuss was about. It only has 14 different screens of play and is arguably too difficult to be enjoyable. The graphics aren't too bad, and this was probably the main reason why it did so well back then. People were seduced by the graphics. However, without sounding too harsh, as helicopter action games go, it's not terrible. There are certainly worse, but in my opinion, Airwolf is not a retro game classic. It is an example how archaic video games did well back then, because we didn't know any better, and because publisher Elite pumped out thousands of pounds into marketing. I suppose pumping out these average games back then was a contributing factor to that video game crash of 1983. Therefore, I'm going to rate this game 6 out of 10 stars. Not a terribly easy game, and a bit of a letdown for fans of this series. Still, Airwolf is nowhere near as bad as the sequel Airwolf 2, so we can at least be thankful that we're not reviewing that one. What a small mercy, eh? Okay folks, that was my short review of the ZX Spectrum 48 game Airwolf. If you liked this video, then please press like. However, it would be great and brilliant, in fact, for you to subscribe to my new channel and become part of the gang. Go on, become part of the gang. Until my next game review, have a great day and keep smiling. See you all very soon. Bye bye.